Y'all think that's bad or you think?
Bro, hold this for a second. Bro, hold this.
When you start to let that perception and that vision of people, when you start to let that cloud you, and like what every girl I ever talked to, I ever see, she don't look like her, then she ain't worth my time. When it's like that, then it becomes a problem. But as long as you're not letting that one person and how their body type is, as long as you're not letting it cloud you and cloud how you judge other people, I mean, it's fine.
But like, okay, what about other things? Because what you guys talked about as far as us, it's always, you know, it's main stuff, like how she looks. You know what I'm saying? Go ahead, bro. All
right, I want to add something. It don't really depend on how a woman dresses. It's about, like, her drive. If a woman can, she can dress in the latest outfits, but if her drive is nowhere, that's a big turnoff. Like, it's a lot of females to walk around here just because you're in college don't mean you're going somewhere. Like, you can be fly going to the party, but if you got no drive and you can't push the guy that you with to do better, and he do the same for you, then the relationship is nothing anyway.
Another relationship goal I see a lot, which is a good goal to me, but sometimes it gets taken out of proportion, is if you guys seen the picture of like it's a dude on one side and a woman on the other side crying, like kissing the Bible. Y'all ever seen that before?
Pictures up like that's all we do. We don't do no sinning. The only thing we talk about is Jesus. You know what I'm saying? Like people putting on like God is the center of my relationship. That's our main focus. If God in the middle, then ain't no. You know what I'm saying? Like being extra and they putting on. Alan, see, that's real rude.
No, it's not about you. The reason we were laughing about myself is because, like, I've been in that relationship, in that situation. I've been in that situation, and I felt like I had to be somebody else just to fit this or sell this kind of image of who we are as a group, as a unit. You know what I'm saying? And I didn't like that. I kind of like resented her for it.
And that goes along with being equally yoked, you know? So like, if your partner is into the, you know, Christianity and hard on religion and all that stuff, she gonna have to be, or he is gonna have to be with someone who's on that same level. So it's not the end of the world if you discover that that one person is on this level and you're not. You're not meant to be together.
Right.
Simple as that.
Let me ask this though. With being equally yoked, like people misinterpret and think, you know, a good Christian is just somebody who can quote the Bible. The devil quoted the Bible.
Right.
Or a Bible toter, somebody who's acting self-righteous. That's not the case.
Right.
So who's to say what equally yoked is? Just because, you know, this person doesn't know the scripture or can quote the scripture.
I think somebody who's working towards what I'm working towards.
Right.
Yeah. If you try to go to church, I'm telling you we're working towards. We don't have to be on the same level, but we got to be working towards
towards that same
goal. Okay, right.
What does that mean? What does that mean?
Like, if I'm, like, trying to get my life together and I'm trying to figure out exactly where I'm supposed to be, what I'm supposed to do, how I'm supposed to live my life according to Jesus, you need to be working your way up there, too.
Mm-hmm. Does that mean going to church?
Like, if I'm going to church, I don't need you going around selling weed out.
It could be as simple as both of y'all have a study session. You know what I mean? Y'all both pushing each other to do, you know, get a common goal. Like, it don't necessarily gotta be religious, but I mean, it can be like, y'all can have like similar goals, put it like that. Like, y'all both want to achieve the same thing.
Even morals, like, not necessarily, you know what I'm saying? Just make sure y'all got the same mindset, like y'all on the same page as far as what's right and what's wrong. That's where it starts. Mm-hmm. You can think all day, I go to church, I'm a good person. You don't have to, it's devils in the church too.
Thank God.
You know what I'm saying? So, well, okay, thank you. So, I mean, I don't think that defines it, but it should be, like, not necessarily, oh, all of us should depend on the Bible, but it need to be y'all on the same page. You know what I'm saying? Or at least working to get there, like Catherine said. So,
it's
just...
I was thinking about this the other day, and I think I was talking to you about it. And, like, I feel like this generation especially, we've gotten so wrapped up in, like, social media, which I call social media, all it is fantasy. Like, if we would rather be either in the future or the past than in the present. You know, even in relationships, like, that's why we look at this person's relationship. Because what's ironic is the same thing you're envying somebody about in their relationship, they're probably envying you about the same thing in yours. It's that whole grass is green on the other side thing. You know what I'm saying? So my question is, like, why is it that we never feel like content? Why is it that we focus more on, you know, what he doesn't have, what she doesn't have, than what she does have? What do you think that comes from? I say, why do you think we're not easily content? Like, why do you think we focus more on, say, what he's doing wrong, what she's doing wrong, what she or he doesn't have, than what they do?
Because people focus on their own happiness, that's why. You know what I'm saying? Like, if he's not doing something right and it's not making you happy, that's what you're going to focus on. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? I mean, maybe not in that perspective, but, like, if he's doing something good, then you happy. But if he do something wrong, you mad at that moment, so that's what you're going to focus on.
Ask us a question.
I know, I'm sorry. part of it is like why some people aren't easily content. Like, it's because, you know, everyone's not focused on the same thing. You know, like, this person maybe got in a relationship for one thing, you got in a relationship for another thing. And that's a part of it. And sometimes it could be the fact that you're curious to experience other things because of your past relationship. And you're basing everything from your past relationship. Trying to make something new, but you still have something lingering from that.
I think at the same time, a lot of people are focused on what they want in the future, but they're not looking at what you got to go through right now to get there. You so focused on, all right, I want him to be here, here, and here. If you in college and you date somebody in college, he ain't going to be a Fortune 500 CEO. He's going to be in college trying to pay this tuition like I'm in college trying to pay this tuition. So you got to focus on what's going to get you there. If you so focused on where you want to be and not how you're going to get there, you're never going to be happy.
She's spitting bars. I told you she would.
I was saying this the other day too. Like, nowadays, like, I feel bars. Like our society, like, we always want everything right in front of us right now. Like, this generation, and, like, it sucks. Like, it sucks bad. Because, like, we don't believe in building anything anymore. Like, we want everything already packaged together, like you were saying. And it sucks because, like, you never know what somebody can blossom into or what y'all can become if you shut them down from the get-go. You know, relationships can't be built in a matter of 2 or 3 weeks. You have to be able to accept that person's flaws or whatever it is at the moment, and then see if y'all can help each other build off of that. But I feel like we don't do that anymore. Like, we just want everything right now.
Do y'all think most people get into a relationship to help somebody or for somebody to help them?
It depends on the person, man.
each person has individual has their own individual motive. Like there's not a one size fit all answer to that one. Like I know for me personally, like my main intent in life in general, like my main intent is to help other people. Like that's just what I do. So in a relationship, I find myself taking on her challenges and making it our challenges. And in return, she does the same thing. Now, I know when I've been in previous relationships where I've made her challenges my challenges, and my challenges were just my challenges. And like I said, it just depends on the person that you're with. And it goes back to what I said earlier. If that person is not for you, like I understand you want to fight and fight to save it, but at the end of the day, you have to realize not everybody is for you. So you can't please everybody.
With the pictures and stuff, like, what do you think that has caused? Like, what do you think it makes us subconsciously want? You know, because I feel like, say back in the day, a guy going after a girl, a girl going after a guy, the girl's perspective was more like, let me find out of my town, whatever. Let me find the guy who I feel like is the hardest worker, or things like that, or the best provider who'll be a good father. And vice versa with men. Let me find a woman who can, you know, take care of my house and take care of my kids. And it's kind of still like that, but now it's more like, okay, let me find a guy who can, you know, so when we take this selfie, we'll look bomb as a couple. Or let me find a girl who, you know, I can use as a trophy for my homeboys. Like, when did you think that happened? Like, when it became more about just superficial stuff, just being vague and just ask you stuff you need. Feel me? What do y'all think that happened?
I feel like it always happens. Yeah. Just a rateness between maturity and immaturity. Like someone who is mature enough to look for a substance in a relationship, they aren't going to be looking at that, you know. Whereas someone who's just looking for surface stuff, those people that are like, oh, let me post, you know, me a thing, like swatches and stuff like that. I feel like those people that actually feel like that's the base of their relationship, those are those people that, you know, look at the superficial things. But it really ranges between the level of maturity and immaturity.
Alright, let me ask y'all this. If your significant other does not post you on their social network, you feel like they love you any less? Somebody speak on it.
That's sneaky. Like, if you're just saying, I don't want to push you up there, then I'm going to really feel some way, because, you know.
I mean, you know why.
But we all give the same excuse. I don't want people in my business. That's not even fair.
Like, okay, you can't say it because you already have a social media. It's a social media, so you can't say you don't want, yeah, people in your business. If you don't do it in your business, then don't have a social media. So you can't really use that.
So if he doesn't do it, how do you feel about him? Or how do you feel about him?
I don't really know, because I've never been in a situation where I'm like, okay, put me on your, just so you don't say it, nobody told me no, so I can't really say how I'm feeling, but I mean, tell me no, like, what? I would probably really be mad. Why not?
I'm saying, like, go ahead. What does that mean? What does it mean?
I mean, I feel like, if it's just a picture, if you're saying it's just a picture, just put on social media, then why can't you just put up just a picture? If it's not really a big deal.
I think it comes back to, like,
something.
I saw something the other day. It was like, are you single, or are you internet single? Maybe he trying to be internet single. That's why he not putting on his Instagram.
I mean, that's what we think.
Because he want everybody to think he's single. But I mean, personally,
I give
we didn't really think we ain't about social media at that point no more. We thinking what you got going on, so what you can't put me on, like, why
Okay, so like, remember when Facebook and basically your relationship status? If y'all get in a relationship, the dude doesn't change or the girl doesn't change. What do you think that means? I'm trying to bring it back to the moment. No, because y'all know back in the day, like, that was the thing to do. Once you got in a relationship, you changed it, and it fluctuated based on, you know, where y'all was at. It's complicated. Y'all have 14-year-olds married and stuff like that. But most of the time...
I was with that dude before, and I didn't take that seriously, so I mean,
all right. It's still kind of like that. If there's no pictures of the dude or the girl or whatever you mess with, you're like, oh, you don't want people to know?
Yeah, I would say if you can't show me a photo, then you don't deserve me to
show me.
You know what I'm saying?
I can't get a whole bunch of pictures.
I think that is wrong. You know what? You cannot quantify your love for someone over a picture on the internet. I mean, if a guy doesn't put your picture on the internet, doesn't mean maybe he might have other reasons. I think you shouldn't see it as a big deal. So it's not a must. Your boyfriend might or must have your picture on online on social media. I mean, you cannot judge him based on that. Because I think there are other important stuff apart from having your picture online. And I mean, I think for me, he might have other million reasons not to put your picture. Maybe he feels it's not the right time, you know. But hey, to me, if I don't have a girl's picture on Facebook or so, it doesn't mean I don't like her. I might still love her, but I don't have a picture there. Because I think it's not the time. I mean, you have to take some steps.
Well, when is the time?
But that's it. I mean, to make a woman public, it's not easy. It's not an easy thing, you know?
One day, people just like, okay, that's a picture on Instagram. They just like, no. It's just, y'all, I mean, don't look like crazy because you know something wrong with it. Like, why would you put your girlfriend on your Instagram?
Would you
not? And why not? Even if she asked you, like, just to not even try to show off, you just like, you know what I'm saying? Because she just want to take a picture on your Instagram. But she won't tell herself.
Real test. Check his Instagram and see what his reaction.
Okay, this question was directed towards the females, but what about the males? If your girlfriend doesn't put you on her Instagram, you know she got all these dudes following her from every which place around every which web. How you gonna feel?
It's not like that.
Okay, the reason I wouldn't put my girlfriend on Instagram is because personally I don't equate showing off to love. You know, I value the stuff people don't see. You know, people gotten so wrapped up in, oh, this picture, that picture, whatever. Like, I value, you know when Drake said, hair tied, tail up, and don't make a woman. She's not gonna let you take a picture of her, man, but that's the picture that you value. You feel what I'm saying? So, first of all, that's
good. Okay.
That's
fine. Y'all can be there, like, it could be 2 years before she even said something about puts on Instagram. So, after those 2 years, y'all just have to have to do it. Y'all don't be playing, dude.
I would post a picture of me if I had a girlfriend or whatever, based off of how serious we were.
Exactly.
Because I don't like to be embarrassed. And like, you feel what I'm saying? Like, I don't want to post a picture and be, and I'm not sure how strong, you know what I'm saying? I'm not sure if I want to last or what. I need confirmation that this relationship is going to be sturdy, because I don't want to put something up and then have people like, oh man, y'all, you know, people put in relationship, then they put no relationship, then they put, like.
What's confirmation? Because it's just as embarrassing, maybe even more. You going back and deleting a picture of somebody you've been with for 2-3 years.
No,
that's my girlfriend. That's my wife. Everybody knows it. That's what we struggle for, God and man. A relationship is a God and man. It's just God.
So you, okay, so just because you have a girlfriend, because she's your girlfriend, you're not supposed to be your girlfriend. I'm not saying it's a must. I'm just saying why not. Like, if I want you, if I'm your lady and you say you love me, I just want to picture on your Instagram. You tell me no. Like, you know what I'm saying? I need to know. Okay, every time I reach you, every week I'm
going to come back. I got something.
It's not the picture, it's the caption under the picture. So like, you can post, I can post a picture with Diamond, let people think, that's my girlfriend, I don't give a fuck.
That's what I'm saying, you didn't even have to put a caption. You don't have to put a caption. If I'm
there, that's my girlfriend. Okay. But yeah, it's not the picture, it's the caption. Like, if you post a picture and it's just the picture, you can say, my friend, okay, that's your friend. You say, my girlfriend, that's your girlfriend. So it's not the picture, it's the caption under.
Well, I want to ask a question. Earlier question. Why is it embarrassing to have to go back and delete pictures that you were with somebody from 2 years ago? All that means is that at some point there was growth. So at some point, one of y'all grew up or one of y'all grew apart, but that means somewhere in the line, somebody stopped growing while the other one kept going. So why is that embarrassing? I'm not going to be embarrassed because I have to be embarrassed. If me and him just didn't turn up on the same page, then we just weren't meant to be. Like he said, everybody's not equally yoked. You're yoked. You might think you equal at that point, but at some point, somebody yoked becomes bigger than the other. So why is that embarrassing?
I'm gonna give you two answers. So, okay, why it's embarrassing is because that might be a reason why some people break up. But another reason some people break up is the whole, you weren't who I thought you were. You know,
it didn't work though. At some point, you get with somebody, at least I would hope, when you get with somebody, you thinking, okay, well, at least at this age now, you thinking, okay, this is somebody I really want to work with. You know what I'm saying? And then you just get a relationship just to get in the dang old relationship. So you can't go into a thinking like, okay, it's all my habits, so I'm not going to put it on Instagram. How can you go on unless you're thinking like that? So, you get in a relationship just to like,
no, I was asking why you would be embarrassing to leave a picture.
I know, but that's what she asked that question because
My second answer is, and dudes talk about this sometimes. You know, it's one of our fears. Cause like I said 2 weeks ago or something, we're scared too. Whatever. Yeah.
No, before you finish, I want you to say what you
say
first. Cause you say dudes, people all
of them. No, you know how when we get into a relationship, we start talking to somebody. We all have fears. Girls are scared of getting their heart broke. Dudes are also scared of getting their heart broke. But it's two different like perspectives of heartbreak. The dudes, I speak for the dudes. Our fear is. Our fear is like, especially in the beginning, like what dudes do is we go around asking all our friends about the girl. Yo, you know what's her name? You heard about it. You know what I'm saying? Y'all do it too, but I'm just speaking for us. Like, we do it, but it's from that fear of looking stupid. Like, we don't want to be, no dude wants to be the dude who wifed up a hoe.
Who caught a dude who been sleeping around with every girl? We don't want to be that either. So I call bullshit on both.
Yeah, I'm not saying y'all don't.
Everything you're saying what y'all feel and everything like that. But that's the same way girls think. Y'all, when it comes to relationships, I feel like most of us, whether you be male or female, you have the same mindset. I'm not gonna get in a relationship. I'm gonna ask, trust me, girls, we better investigators than y'all. So I'm gonna find out.
You're right.
I'm gonna find out what life is for you. I'm gonna find out where you are. So it's like to say that you're only doing it
so you won't look stupid. We don't want to look stupid either. And I feel like as girls, we sometimes might hold others' opinions more highly than guys do. We do. So for us to look stupid, it's more, it hurts us more than it probably hurts y'all, because when we look stupid, y'all don't have the bold guys coming up to y'all, "Oh, nah, I fucked it the other day." But we got the bold hoes who come up to us. Now, I was with him last night. Where you was at? He came to my room last night. So it's like, and you have to deal with that, because females become so much more bold as time goes on. So it's like, if I was speaking with anybody, man, I could go up to her and be like, "Oh, shit, you out with him?" Be like, "Damn, I fucked him 2 weeks ago."
But the reason we was like, the reason Alan's point was because, like, I get what you're saying, and it does hurt both ways, but we kind of touched on this a couple weeks ago too. Like, in most cases, you got some exceptions, so I can't say every time, but a lot of times, like, for a dude, just by our nature, like, if you decide to be with a girl, like, it take a lot to get to that point, though. Like, it takes a lot. Like, girls, I feel like it's, y'all do this investigation, whatever, but I feel like y'all get with people faster than dudes. Officially, for a dude to officially say, "This is my girl." Y'all don't understand. It takes a lot.
Especially today.
In 2015.
Well, then that depends on each individual person, because I guess you would say I'm the same way, because we could be talking for 2 years and you'd be like, "So we gonna start dating?" Be like, "You sure you wanna do this? This is moving kind of fast." If you ask me, if we 2 years in, like.
That's what I'm saying, but I'm just thinking I'm just faster than women. Like,
You should. But that's why I said if he's a good dude, he appreciates his girl.
How about the women in the room? Do y'all have any questions for us? Like, some things y'all think we expect that's unrealistic?
You said what?
I said, do you think anything that men expect is stupid or unrealistic or, you know, like, stupid or unrealistic? Do you think? Is there anything with, because we've been talking pretty much from a male perspective, like y'all putting pictures up, going to meet them, things like that. Y'all think this stuff we expect that y'all don't agree with?
Come on now.
So, okay, let me ask you this. If a girl doesn't put up a picture of a boyfriend, should we feel some kind of way?
To be honest, I mean, I'm not even going to look like now. Because I ain't gonna post a picture, then okay, we can do that. But right now, I wouldn't even post them. So it's like, I mean, it depends on the person. But I'm not gonna be like, if he want a picture, I ain't gonna be like, no. Like, that's sneaky. He gonna be like, well, why should I want to put a picture up? You know what I'm saying? So, like, I don't post them. It depends on the person.
What if he tell you to post a picture of how many people on that level?
I mean, you can still post a picture. You ain't got to put a picture and be like, my love and my friend, all that stuff. You can post a picture. A picture is just a picture. What people assume is what they assume. But if I want to post a picture, I'm going to post a picture.
That just reminded me of another question. Go ahead.
Do y'all not post it? Because she just said something about, like, are y'all afraid that, like, dudes gonna follow the girl? Because my man was having an issue.
I ain't taking like, shit.
The last picture I took of me and my boyfriend, that's the first time I've ever taken in any picture. Because I don't like to just like, they like to take photos.
That's what I'm saying. As soon as you post it, you got something to say. When you post it, like, oh, I did this and that. This is necessary. Like, nah, you ain't.
I got a question. Yes, now. To those that oppose tagging your boyfriend in the picture, you mentioned that you don't want other women following him. Now, my take on that is, why are you concerned about what the other females doing? You need to be concerned about him.
Right.
It takes two to tangle. So like, they can send all the love they want, but he don't have to reciprocate. Now, if he's reciprocating, that's an issue.
And that's true, but females still don't want to see him.
Exactly.
They still don't want to see
him. I had a friend, and I told her, I was like, oh, yeah, I'm talking to this dude. You know, she's like, what's his name? I told her, and you know, she was like, oh, I don't know him. And then I just so happened to see on my little follower name, the bitch, and I started following him. I'm like, what the fuck are you following him? Like, I just wanted to see what he was about. What the fuck you gotta do that for? She said she was a conniving little person, you know, so I'm just like, she was sneaky anyway. Okay. So that confirmed it. We ain't cool
enough. But my thing is, it's nothing.
But she got mad all over there.
You may think the world of your significant other, but don't everybody want them? So, like, just because they're getting a lot of likes or whatever, don't mean nobody wants them. Just because they hang around a lot of different people, don't everybody want them. So it's up to you as a person to trust your significant other. Don't worry about the other people. Worry about him or her.
You gotta be honest with yourself too.
Right. If you trust your significant other, you don't care who they're around. Because they can that girl or that dude can do whatever they want to your significant other. Your significant other ain't reciprocating that love or whatever, then what are you worrying about?
Let me piggyback off of that. But like somebody asked me, it's like in relationships whenever I'm talking to somebody, whatever the case may be, I'm not a jealous type of person. Like, it's just not in me, you know, to be envious or jealous or whatever the case may be. But a lot of people use that to, like, equate that to love. Like, since he's not jealous and he ain't checking for me and worrying about what I'm doing. And the thing about females, I'm sorry, I had to pick on y'all again, is that sometimes, because y'all test that. Y'all test that sometimes. And sometimes you might say, oh, you know, somebody DM me today, just to get a rise out of it. I know a lot of people do.
That is extremely.
Go ahead, brother.
Hey, I can agree with you on that.
Go ahead, brother.
Everybody jealousy, you know, may not be on 10, but hey, if a dude creeping that DM, you... I can agree with you on that because everybody got a little bit of jealousy in them. It might take a lot to get proud of, but
I feel like that might be the case, but I feel like, you know, just like Al said, if you doing, because we're as human beings, we're scared of being inadequate. We're scared of not being good enough, right? So I feel like if you're doing everything you feel like you're supposed to be doing to help this person, like, ask me if I've eaten today, not who, what bitch was that who liked the picture.
I say that just to make him feel good sometimes. I trust my man and he trusts me. You know what I'm saying? I might do that and he was yesterday. He said, I had said, who was that girl who asked you if you used to play football or something like that?
That don't make us feel good. That's stressful.
It's stressful. Well,
But she's not saying all the time. You do it every once in a while to feed his ego a little bit.
Even once in a while, the fact that we know y'all creeping and know who is asking us questions, that is stressful.
We ain't really creeping though. It's just you having to look at it. You know, it's just keep it moving with.
Hey, let's talk one at a time. If you have something to say, you know, speak up or raise your hand or whatever the case may be, because everybody talking at once is really important. But, yeah, so go back.